honorable Mr. State, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and Electronics and IT, Secretary Meiti, President NASCOM, my colleague Abhishek, all the other colleagues in the audience, ladies and gentlemen. I think the week-long event as part of the Azadi Ka Amrit Digital Mahotsav are very timely and relevant as they give us an opportunity to really celebrate the achievements that Meiti has done in the last several years. They also give us a chance to reflect on our future vision and priorities. And they give us a chance to also examine as to how we can meet those challenges that may arise in the future. Meiti can justifiably be very proud of the achievement under the digital program in the last 7 years. On several fronts, we have done very well, be it digital governance, where we have created truly national and global scale digital platforms like Aadhaar, the government marketplace, we have the GST network, we have the mobile platforms, which are truly world class. And many other national leaders can aspire to where we have reached in that in those areas. We also have done very well in electronic manufacturing, where we are now among the world's largest mobile device manufacturers, and we are rapidly advancing our capability in other domains of manufacturing. So what does the future entail for Meiti, and what we should be doing to really address those challenges? We will just briefly mention about some of the key areas that I think are very relevant as we move towards next few years of our journey. As you are all aware, in the post-pandemic world, we are seeing much greater adoption of digital. And along with that, there are challenges emerging which we all should be aware of. In this scenario, the areas where we need to focus upon are, we must move from the focus currently today on applications to platforms. We already have done a lot of work with many domain ministries in this regard, and we hope to really continue the effort in this direction. We also need to really focus on the vision of Aatmanirbhar Bharat in manufacturing, in electronics manufacturing, where again the efforts underway to really achieve this vision. We also need to focus on emerging technology, which is the key area where I think the future advances of our nation would lie, those which can really do well with advanced research and development in areas like AI, machine learning, 5G, IoT, etc. They really stand to gain competitive advantage in that in those areas. We also need to focus on cyber security, where India has really made very significant progress in the last few years. Currently, we are ranked 10th in the world in the global cyber security index, which is a rise of 37 places from where we were last year. So that's another area where we really need to constantly be on watch in terms of the emerging threats and our efforts to really counter them and become proactive in meeting those threats. We also need to focus on putting in place a sound legal framework to really address the emerging challenges in the digital domain. And as we're all aware, the PDC bill, the Personal Protection Bill, is an effort in that direction, and we hope that in the coming months when this becomes a law, we will have the world's most contemporaneous and advanced framework for handling personal data, which would give us a big boost to the data economy that we hope to take advantage of because of our IT capabilities. And we would really like that India becomes the world's most advanced nation in the digital domain. I think if we focus on these areas, certainly we can meet the challenges that we foresee coming in the future in the digital domain, and we can really be proud of what we have achieved. In the startup space also, we are very strong. We are the world's third largest startup ecosystem. And in fact, today, there was a news that today we have a 37th unicorn born this year in the startup area, which is again, I think, really remarkable and praiseworthy. And if you really see the innovation in the fintech space, that's something that we can really be proud of. Nowhere in the world we see so much of innovation happening in the startup area, but in some domains we are very strong. We need to really focus on the areas where we need to grow and ensure that we can really become the world's most competitive nation in the business space. So with this word, let me congratulate the various divisions within MIT, which have taken all the pains to really organize this week-long event, and all my best wishes to all the teams for really doing even better in the future. Thank you very much. So for the kind words, NASSCOM has been a valued partner in digital media initiatives, and today we have President NASSCOM, Ms. Devajani Ghosh amongst us, who we very often consider to be an integral part of MIT. Now I invite Ms. Ghosh to deliver her address on this special occasion.
Mr. Chandrasekhar, Mr. Sami, Dr. Kumar, Abhishek, congratulations on this beautiful day where we are launching the ABC of Summit of India at 75. You know, when we think about India at 75, we think about the future of technology, we think about the future of responsibility. Who could believe that a country where that actually uses a unique ID, a 12-digit ID, my height always has to be accounted for. So who would believe that a country using 12-digit unique ID would be able to find missing children on a daily basis and unite them with their families? I mean, can you imagine anything that is more heartbreaking, that is more scary than a parent losing a child or a child getting lost from their home? You know, Abhishek recently told me a heartwarming story that in 2017, a 17-year-old boy who had speech and hearing impairment boarded a train from Raipur by mistake and was lost. He reached Jharsuguda, and the next day, he was found in a very traumatic condition by the Child Welfare Committee, who immediately got into action, directed that his fingerprints be scanned. His image was matched to Aadhaar fingerprint scan, and his address was traced, and he was safely returned home. All over India, we have had successful cases, numerous cases, where missing children have been traced thanks to India's Aadhaar and have been returned to their families. Now, you know, when we think about technology and the power of technology, the world in the last 2 years during the pandemic woke up to this concept of technology for good. The world woke up to this concept of inclusive technology. The technology should not just be used to create companies which are tremendously powerful and rich, but the technology should be used to improve human life. As an Indian, I feel tremendously proud that for years now, I still remember the first AI, artificial intelligence meeting that MIT had organized, I was invited to. It went on for like 5 or 6 hours with different stakeholders coming in to talk about what was possible in India. And across the room, each and every one of us agreed that the first design principle for artificial intelligence in India had to be artificial intelligence for all. It had to be inclusive. As a country, I strongly believe that we are showing the world the true meaning of technology for good, the true meaning of inclusive technology. I mean, just if you look at the Aadhaar number, 71 crore residents have linked Aadhaar with ration card to just array basic supplies like food supplies. 100% farmers, that is 11.9 crore, have given Aadhaar for receiving benefits. In FY 2020-2021, we Indians have used our Aadhaar ID 1,400 crore times to avail of services. And that's the power of technology when it gives you access to the basic services, to the most needed services, and it starts at the bottom of the pyramid and not at the top. You know, I strongly believe that India at 75 will be an India that is leading the world on unleashing the true power of technology, the true potential of technology. Technology as the greatest equalizer. Technology that creates higher productivity or drives higher productivity, that creates a world where we humans are at the center of the world and not technology. And I strongly believe that India is doing that today. And we will continue to do that. And the world will be looking at us to figure out how do we create a world that is truly human-centric and that is truly inclusive. I have to give kudos to Mighty and the entire team at Mighty for laying the foundation of such a world, for laying the foundation that allows us to have this big dream of India leading the world when it comes to inclusive tech, when it comes to tech for good. And the fantastic work that Mighty has done in respect to the digital public good platform, which I can go on and on talking about, because I just think it is mind-blowing what has been created. I mean, you think of the digital economy, every economy needs infrastructure, needs roads. Think of the digital economy. How many countries have successfully created digital highways that connect everyone across the digital economy? Doesn't matter if you're a farmer sitting in a village or if you're a businessman sitting in Mumbai and running a $1 billion business. It connects everyone. Equal access to everyone, to healthcare, to vaccination, to finance, name it. And this is the power of technology, and this is what India is showing the world how it can be done. So once again, kudos to the entire Mighty team. Mr. Sony, you have lit a spark in all of us by creating this concept of Team India. And I think, as I've told you this, but I think that is what, you know, energizes all of us to just do a little bit more and make it happen, because possibilities are endless. In my first meeting with Mr. Chandrasekhar, he told all of us that he had only one ask from the industry. We had to reimagine our aspiration. And personally for me, couldn't have been a better ask than that. Because this is not just India's time, but this is the time of possibilities. This is the time of technology. This is the decade. And as the Prime Minister said, we have to ensure that we make this India's decade, not just with focus on innovation, but with focus on impact. With focus on impact at the bottom of the grassroots. With focus on scale. With focus on sustainability. With focus on inclusion. We India will show the world the true power of technology for good. And I firmly believe there is nothing more powerful than changing a human life. Thank you very much.